The sun is out, the wind is mild. It's a great day to be in rifle country. And today, what I'm going to talk about is my home defense rifle. Now specifically, this gun, from a technical standpoint, is not a rifle. It's a pistol. If you look back here, you will see that there is a stabilizing brace. Yes, indeed, this is a stabilizing brace. And the barrel on this upper receiver is 14.5 inches. Why did I choose a rifle for a home defense gun? Well, I chose a rifle for a home defense gun because regardless of the handgun caliber you're talking about, 9, 40, 45, 44, 357, whatever. The fact of the matter is, no handgun will ever be as powerful of a stopping tool as a .223 cartridge. This gun is relatively compact. It's not too compact, but it's compact enough that you can move around in a house, around furniture, around corners, and so forth. Let's talk about some vital aspects or some critical items that should be mounted on your home defense rifle. On this side, you'll notice that I have a flashlight. This is an Enforce light, and I purchased it from the Brownells website. And it's mounted to a Magpul forend. We've got a Magpul forend right here with a Weaver rail, and I was just able to mount it right directly there. Now, what do I have up top? I have an Aimpoint red dot. Now this red dot is their less expensive version, I guess you could say. There's lots of different types of Aimpoints, and this is the Aimpoint Pro, the PRO. Now with this optic, you put a battery in there and it will last literally thousands of hours. Thousands of hours. So when I installed the battery and I zeroed this sight on this gun, I set it on the medium setting and I leave it turned on. I never turn it off. I just leave it all the time. So that if I wake up in the middle of the night because there's a crash, bang, dogs are barking, and I reach out and I grab this rifle, I throw it up in my shoulder, there's a red dot there and it's ready to go. Now, what else do I have on this? Because of the way the Pro is set up, it has this quick attach mount, which is nice, but that's kind of, well, it's kind of in the way. So I put an extended charging handle on here just in case I have to work this. Not that big of a deal, but that's why I put that there. I also have, obviously, a front sight tower, and I have a backup sight, which is zeroed 1-to-1 with the red dot sight. What ammunition do I have in this gun? Thank you very much for asking. There's a lot of different types of 5.56, 223 ammunition available, lots of different bullet designs and so forth. When it comes to deliberately stopping a fleshy target, something that is made of flesh and bone and it wants to hurt me, I choose the Mark 262 that is a 77 grain BTHB or OTM, depending on who you buy it from. Now the ammunition that I've got in this magazine right here comes from Black Hills, and I know some of you guys are saying, well, where I live, the local shop that I shop at and so forth, they don't sell Black Hills ammunition, or I have to buy a whole case of it and I don't want to do that. Okay, fine. Nosler makes the SSA ammunition. This is the Nosler SSA, and if you look closely, it's a genuine 5.56, and it is a 77 grain OTM. That stands for open tip match. And I can tell you from personal experience that a 5.56 with a 77 grain bullet, the OTM, BTHP, whatever you want to call it, does a fantastic job on fleshy creatures. Living creatures that are made of flesh and bone that you need to put down, this projectile does a fantastic job on those. Now the one last thing that I want to talk about, there's other features on here, I Duracoated this, and I've got the Magpul forend and so forth, but right up front, right here. Now if you're going to be using a gun, a rifle, or a rifle caliber pistol, as a home defense gun, and you have to touch off around, it's going to be loud. It's going to be extremely loud. Many of you are thinking, well, I live in free America, I'll get a suppressor, a silencer, a moderator, I'll put it on there, calm down the noise. That's great. Not everyone can do that. But what you can do is you can purchase a brake or muzzle device just like this one. This is the Spikes Tactical Barking Spider Muzzle Brake. Not a suppressor, not a silencer, but what it does is it effectively takes that loud noise, the gas is what makes the noise, and it pushes it out away from your face. When you're using short-barreled guns, you need something on the end of that muzzle that pushes the gas away from your face, not to the sides, to the walls, and what have you. I know a lot of you guys got these cool comps and brakes and stuff. If you're in a hallway and you have a cool comp brake on your gun, you press off a shot, it sends the gas straight out to the hallway walls, and guess where it comes back to? Your head. You don't want that. So if you're going to have some type of a home defense rifle in .223, you want something up front, like this Barking Spider brake, that will move the gas away from your face, towards the target. Push the gas towards the target and away from your face. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for a home defense rifle. What are the important things? A 30-round magazine. If you live in slave country, sorry, sucks to be you. 30-round magazine, a flashlight, a red dot, some type of muzzle device.